Incremental greetings. So you know that incremental reading is tough to learn, takes some patience at the beginning, but we can simplify that. You just require 5 basic skills in order to do incremental reading. By the way, this is based on the official incremental reading manual. This is a tough read, so what I will do is simplify. Especially if you are not used or familiar with Supermemo, the article will be too hard. I will cover each skill on its own chapter in this video. First, it's importing articles because, hey, I want to read this, I want to read this other thing, this other article, or perhaps a video, doesn't have to be written. Then I will put it in my collection so I can process it in the future. And what happens? I can import in many ways, yes, but what I think is the most important is that I'm adding something on the queue, on the priority queue. How important is this new piece of information I'm adding that is waiting to be processed? So where do I put it in my priority queue? That's fundamental that everything in incremental reading has a priority. So everything is in order from the most important to the least important. So if I add someone new that was not in the queue, where do I put it? How important it is? That's a skill that you will require some practice. For example, that's the old importer. You can decide the priority range, the contact groups, and more stuff. But the skill is what deserves to be imported, the importability threshold, and how important that would be, the priority that it deserves. Second skill about reading articles is, wait, I just imported stuff, material, because I want to read that material. And how do you read in incremental reading is very different of how you may read in an orthodox way. Let's put it on those words. So let's do an example. Okay, so that missing letter effect. So that is the most recent non-processed article I have here in this collection. So what I will do is I will start reading. But hey, in incremental reading, the reading is interrupted. There is an interruption, and this interruption is a feature. It's not that, hey, you have an option that you can interrupt the reading. No. It has to be interrupted, or instead will be just linear. Here is incremental, in the sense that it's non-linear, and on top of that, I don't have to start from the beginning. If it's incremental reading friendly enough, I could also alter the order. So let me do one example. What is the second skill of reading? So this is presented to me, and I will read. In cognitive psychology, the missing letter effect refers... In cognitive psychology, the missing letter effect refers to finding that when people are asked to consciously detect target letters while reading a text, they miss more letters in frequent function words, as an example, the letter H in the, than in less frequent content words. Okay, so this is me giving just a definition, slightly verbose, but it's good enough. So I have the interruption here. I move on. I won't be reading more today, and I will continue next time. That's the reading, in incremental reading. And could be a video or an audio. It's not limited to text, by the way. In this skill, in the second skill, what's still relevant is the priority. Because what could have changed is that now it has a priority of 3%, more or less, in my position 1000. This position will be changing with my collection size, so I don't care. It's relevant the relative position on the queue, 3%. It's high priority. But wait, that's the priority I used during the first skill, importing the article. So part of the repetition is to assess, hey, is this priority reflecting today's priority, or may I change it, adjust it? And this follow the third skill, that once you read, what you will do, could do, it's not required, is extracting fragments of text or video or audio, and at the end of the day, make question and answers of the information you have chosen to remember. Let's follow the example. So in that case, I read this, and it happens that all I read, I want to extract because it's a kind of a definition, and I want to remember this. If I would not, I will just continue next time here with the reading point or delete it. So next time, not now, for the sake of the video, it's now, but in this case, this will be scheduled in 2 days, I will see this extract. So this is rereading already. This text I have read 2 days ago. And in this example was verbatim. I haven't changed anything at all. Which I could. Then I may rearrange this. In this case, I'm familiar enough with the function words. So this example will be gone because I don't need it. Okay. And then I will make what I want to remember. I want to remember the name of this effect. Missing letter effect. And I make the close deletion. This creates a flashcard. So this I'm doing, what I have done now is the same. It's one topic review, but of a subset, of an extract of the entire thing, the entire article. I'm not done this necessarily here. I could do, next time this shows up, I could create more cards if I want to. Then, this skill has another domain, and are the flashcards. This created a flashcard now. That's the front, and that's the backside. In Supermemo, at least, it's not required but by incremental reading, but how it's implemented in Supermemo, most of the time you will create items like this, even if you just want question and answer without using close deletion. But wait, that has a priority. Everything has a priority in incremental reading, which has been inherited from the topic, which was 3%. So part of the repetition is also adjusting the priority. Okay, so we have done the three basic skills. Now I already have the flashcards, but hey, that's not the end. In incremental reading, you don't finish here. The next skill is repetition and review. Repetition for flashcards, review for passive material reading. Let's continue the example. Wait a second. Now I will see this next time. 1 day interval. Then this shows up. In cognitive psychology, the blank refers to the finding that when people are asked consciously, is, hey, I have read this before, right? And in this case, I haven't touched anything. I have only deleted the example. And even if I remember the fact, I successfully recall that, part of the repetition is assessing the priority. Is, A, perhaps today, this deserves a very different priority. So the repetition is not just recalling and grade how well you recalled. That is also the priority. And in case you don't remember this, you'll take some actions. And this is the skill you require. That if I have failed this card, why? Does this connect to other information I know, other knowledge? Or it just asemantic, living on its own, I cannot connect to anything, and therefore it will be a lot harder to remember. How useful is this today? Perhaps I created this 2 years ago, and I realized that, okay, I will still keep it in my collection, but I will set a priority a lot lower, which this skill goes in consonance with the last one. But wait, we are not getting there yet. There's something extremely important, that during the repetitions, you may adjust the question and answers because you haven't created the flashcard in one go. You also do this incrementally. So not that I see it today, won't change much because it only have passed 1 or 2 days. But each time I see this card, I will have more knowledge than the last time. So I may choose to formulate it slightly differently. Perhaps I will require less information because I have solidified information. Or perhaps now I have more information than before I didn't. And it's creating memory interferences. So precisely because before I didn't have that information, I haven't had this issue. So to follow the example, perhaps I will use this wording instead. What is the term used in cognitive psychology to describe the phenomenon where individuals, while actively attempting to identify specific letters in a text, often overlook more letters in common function words compared to rarer content words? So the key point is that you don't make the flashcard right away and it's perfect. You do this iteratively. I just create the item, the flashcard, then I adjust this, I don't need this detail, too much information. So it will become more atomic, more specific, easier to remember. Because this question is not about to check your understanding, the reading comprehension. No. This question is for you to remember, to recall this atomic piece of information. So how the questions are asked are different. This is super important. The skill number 4, repetition and review, that is reassessing priorities and the formulation of knowledge, is what will make a difference in your retention. So usually people who had a very low skill formulation had a lot of issues remembering. They had a lot, huge forgetting index and so on. Now with AI, you can get help. And this skill can be somewhat superseded with AI, with the help of AI. But you have to make this conscious choice that each repetition is unique and you don't just smash the spacebar and it's always the same experience. And this leads us to the last skill, handling large volumes of knowledge. This cannot be avoided. So, for instance, in this collection, I have about 20,000 outstanding or due elements. Can be question and answers in the form of flashcards, can be topics as in extracts, or the full article that has been unprocessed and read yet. I'm not going to finish this. It's impossible. It's too much. But by extracting and making questions and answers, I will be creating more elements in my collection. So I'm making this the collection larger, so the information overflow even greater. Not only that, I will keep importing articles related to what I'm reading or what I want to read. But even if I don't want to read anything new, let's pretend that's the case, just to elucidate some things that I'm not sure I'm learning, I will require to import this. So it's an ever-growing scenario that this volume of information will be bigger and bigger. Therefore, the skills are more critical across time. The longer my collection, the older my collection, the greater effect of the priorities I set, or what I decide to do today and skip. So I will do it next time, and if next time I have more staff, and it's perpetually postponed, I won't see it again in my life. Which you can do by postponing, mercy, there's a lot of stuff you can do in Supermemo. That's a skill, because knowing this, what you may be tempted to do is the opposite. So you will lead to the recency bias. Most of what you read is the recent imported articles, the recent created extracts or questions and answers, which is also is not a good scenario. So at the end of the day, skill number 5 is king, because even if you have mastered all of the 4 skills, in the long run, it's going to be messed up. Keep in mind, this is not a sprint, it's a marathon. It's in the long term. So this is just a snippet, very high level, of what incremental reading is. So the skills you require for doing incremental reading, that, according to Piotr Wozniak, satisfies the definition. This is incremental reading with capital I and capital R. Just this. There's a plethora of features, but the more advanced you go, the more diminishing returns you get. Just to name one, auto postpone or mercy is one of the features that you will likely use once or twice in your life, or very scarcely, once every some years. But when you need to use it, you really need to know what you're doing, or you can screw up big time your collection. I have the Supermemo. To date, it's the only software that is truly implementing incremental reading. Perhaps the future is not. So everything that I shared with you is incremental reading through Supermemo. Remember that, using this tool. But the skills are agnostic to the tool. It's a method. You can do this with any other software. I hope this can be useful. My pleasure to share my two cents, and see you incrementally.